Penguin Random House Audio presents Oak Flat, A Fight for Sacred Land in the American West by Lauren Redniss. Read for you by Lauren Redniss with Darrell Dennis, Kimberly Farr, Kyla Garcia, Kimberly Guerrero, Hillary Huber, Ami Korn, Linda Korn, Anne Marie Lee, Elizabeth Liang,
Crystle Lightning,
John Lindstrom, A. Martinez, John H. Mayer, Arthur Morey, Dan Musselman, and Tanis Parenteau. Note to listeners, this program includes a downloadable PDF that contains a selection of original illustrations by the author from the book.
Chapter 1.
Copper is produced in massive stars and flung out into space as those stars explode. We look into the night sky. The heavens appear still and quiet. But as you gaze upward, you are a distant witness to cataclysmic violence. Each glittering star is a cauldron of nuclear fusion reactions many light years away. The light we see is the release of energy as the star fuses hydrogen into helium. When a star runs out of hydrogen to fuse, it surrenders to gravity and begins to contract. The star's core becomes hotter and denser. This heat and pressure spur further nuclear reactions, forming elements of increasingly higher mass. As a large star burns through all the energy it can generate from fusion, its core tightens into a blazingly hot fist of iron. The star implodes, then rebounds outward, forming a supernova, an explosion bright enough to outshine entire galaxies. The star is dying, collapsing in on itself at velocities of up to 70,000 kilometers per second and spewing dense clouds of hot gas into space at a third of the speed of light, driving a shockwave dozens of light years across. A supernova has the power to forge metallic elements, and as it explodes, it expels these elements into space. In these dense molecular clouds, new stars and planets form. Some 4.5 billion years ago, one of those new stars was our Sun. As cosmic debris orbited the nascent Sun, particles began clumping together, becoming asteroids, planetesimals, and finally, over millions of years, planets, including planet Earth. Young Earth was a seething ball of molten rock and metal. Comets, meteors and asteroids crashed into the new planet. Eventually, Earth's surface began to cool and solidify. Water vapor and ice became oceans. Continents collided, were torn asunder, slid past each other, were reformed. Molten rock known as magma churned under Earth's surface. Magma that spews from Earth in a volcanic eruption is called lava. Magma can also crystallize underground, over hundreds of thousands, or even millions of years. Most magmas cool into common granites, but a small percentage concentrates metals to form an ore deposit. Ore deposits contain coveted minerals, including gold, silver, iron, and copper. Humans have mined these materials for millennia. Today we use mined metals in construction and manufacturing, in medical devices and in agriculture, in power generation and telecommunications. In the 21st century, the ore close to Earth's surface has mostly been harvested, so we dig ever deeper to access what remains. In 1995, a body of copper ore was discovered in southeastern Arizona, on the edge of the mining region known as the Copper Corridor. About 3,000 people live in the nearby town of Superior. The San Carlos Apache Indian Reservation is 15 miles to the east. The land above the ore was federal land, an area of the Tonto National Forest, known as Oak Flat. The copper deposit was huge, one of the world's largest untapped reserves. Whoever mined it stood to reap enormous profit, many billions of dollars. But because the ore was located within a national forest, legislation was required to transfer the land from federal ownership into private hands. In 2014, two of the world's largest mining conglomerates, BHP Billiton and Rio Tinto, formed a subsidiary called Resolution Copper. Resolution Copper began lobbying the U.S. Congress to pass a law that would allow the company to gain possession of the land and access the ore. The company claimed that a mine at Oak Flat would be able to produce 25% of the United States' annual copper demand. Environmentalists balked. A mine would cause irreparable damage. Some residents of Superior supported the proposed mine, optimistic about the jobs it could create. Others objected. They had lived through mining's boom-bust cycle before and were wary. Native Americans protested. Oak Flat, the San Carlos Apache believe, is sacred land. Arizona's copper corridor is wild desert country, with undulating mountains and riparian canyons. The landscape is also studded with man-made canyons, vast, open-pit mines. There is the Asarco Ray copper mine in Kearney, a short drive from Superior, and the Freeport-McMoRan copper and gold mine, 18 miles northeast in the town of Miami. There are the three chasms of the Morenci mine to the east and the defunct Lavender Pit to the south in Bisbee. If you stand at the edge of these mines, you could imagine you have arrived at the ruins of an ancient civilization. You are alone in a colossal abandoned amphitheater. An open-pit mine is as monumental as the pyramids of Giza or Mexico's Teotihuacan. Spiraling ledges descend into the depths of the mine canyon. Canyon walls shimmer in shades of green, blue, pink, red, malachite, azurite, oxidizing iron. An open-pit mine is an enormous gash in the earth, an eyesore so spectacular it becomes sublime. The proposed Resolution Copper mine would be different. It would not be an open pit. The company plans to extract the ore using a method known as block caving, which removes the ore from underneath. Mine shafts would be more than a mile deep, the deepest in North America. Temperatures at the deepest levels would reach 180 degrees Fahrenheit. As Resolution's block caving operation causes progressive layers of earth to fall inward, eventually the ground's surface itself would give way, leaving a crater in the landscape. This is known as subsidence. The company predicts that the subsidence crater would be up to 2 miles wide and 1,000 feet deep. If the mine proceeds as planned, Oak Flat will collapse into the void. The contested copper under Oak Flat was created by stars that were born and died billions of years ago. The copper is older than Earth itself. A mine here would operate for about 40 years. Within Oak Flat's series of remote desert mesas, natural springs flow. There are clusters of old-growth oak trees and outcroppings of volcanic rock. Bears and javelina roam. At night, with little light pollution to dim them, stars shimmer overhead.
Chapter 2.
Nolan Pike.
When I went to Washington, D.C., I wore my buckskin. We walked into this elevator and a guy passed me and he was like, "Wow, your costume's beautiful." I was like, "This is not a costume."
Nolan Pike was 14 in November 2013. She wore braces and dark hair past her waist. Her buckskin, a long fringe dress made from deer hide, was sewn with tin jingles. In D.C., when you walk into the Capitol, you have to get scanned for metal and stuff. I was like, I am so gonna get detected. It was Wednesday. Nalin had skipped school and traveled from Arizona with a small group, including her mother and grandfather, to attend congressional hearings on the proposed mine at Oak Flat.
Nalin Pike.
It was the first time I flew on an airplane. I was so nervous because I'm afraid of heights. We went up and my stomach dropped. I was like, just let me land. But it was fun and we got free drinks or whatever. Everything was new. I'd never been in a taxi.
From the taxi window, Nalin could see the Lincoln Memorial, the Washington Memorial, rows of government buildings. She arrived at the Capitol in the early afternoon. At the building's entrance, as she had predicted, the jingles on her dress set off the metal detector.
Nalin Pike.
The security guards were like, oh my gosh, but I couldn't take my dress off, so they kind of patted me and said, just go. People were staring. Everyone was like, what are you? Like, I'm Apache.
For generations, Apaches have gathered at Oak Flat. Oak Flat is the site of religious ceremonies, including a coming-of-age rite for girls. The Sunrise Dance is a 4-day ritual central to Apache community and culture, during which a girl who has recently begun menstruating reenacts the Apache creation myth. In the past, Oak Flat was also an Apache.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.